All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back on a Recollection Road channel, and we got important jobs that have become obsolete. I can already, there's probably going to be the milkman, the paper boy, and those are the two that come to mind. And what else? I can't think right now. But appreciate you guys coming over and watching. I'll leave the link to their channel in the description so you can check out more. Shout out to all the good humans. We ain't gonna waste no more time. Let's jump right into it.
In the days before computers, teletype operators were the backbone of long-distance communication. They would type out messages on a teletype machine, which would then be transmitted over telegraph lines. These teletype operators were skilled at using the equipment, and their jobs were in high demand. But with the introduction of computers, and later the internet, the need for teletype operators gradually disappeared, and the job became obsolete.
Just wonder if the internet went out, what would we do?
Elevators have come a long way since their invention, and the job of an elevator operator has changed dramatically over the years. Before they were automatic, elevators had to be operated by a person who would manually control the elevator's movements. Elevator operators were highly skilled professionals who knew how to safely transport passengers to their desired floors. However, with the development of automated elevators that were easy to use and safe to operate, the need for human elevator operators diminished completely.
That is pretty crazy if you think about it. Like, I'm just looking at all of these people on the elevator. And nobody could do what he's doing right. Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
In the days before refrigeration, ice was a luxury item and had to be delivered to homes and businesses. Ice delivery men would travel door to door with large blocks of ice, which they would then sell to customers. This was a physically demanding job that required a lot of strength, as the blocks of ice were heavy and unwieldy. So then, along came in-home refrigerators, and they became widespread. Therefore, the need for ice delivery men gradually disappeared.
Delivering ice, man. Wow.
Before every factory and manufacturing facility was automated and using robots, riveters were responsible for joining metal parts together. Riveters would use handheld hammers and special tools to connect the metal, which was a physically demanding job that required a lot of hard work and dedication. This was evident during World War II, when women stepped into these tough roles, while men were overseas. But as automation and robots became more common, the need for human riveters declined steeply, making this another job that has become obsolete.
Well, there was a lot going on.
As computers changed the way we did things, the typewriter was one of those technologies that suffered. So the job of a typewriter repairman was obviously one that would also become rare. Typewriter repairmen were skilled at repairing and maintaining these mechanical devices that were in high demand throughout much of the 20th century. That is, right up until personal computers and digital word processing became a thing. Typewriters today have become antiques that are more collectible than functional. Before electricity turned on lights across every city in this country, lamplighters were responsible for lighting and maintaining gas street lamps. Lamplighters would not only light and maintain the street lamps, but they would also ensure that they burned brightly all night long. As electric lighting became more prevalent and large cities adopted the new technology, the need for lamplighters became a thing of the past.
I think I saw this in another video they did.
Telegraphers were responsible for sending and receiving messages over telegraph wires. This technology was how communication was accomplished before the telephone. The job of a telegrapher meant using Morse code to encode and decode messages by way of the telegraph system. Sheesh. But as telegraphs themselves were replaced by telephones and later other forms of communication, the demand for telegraphers became obsolete.
Man.
Just like with ice delivery and before in-home refrigeration in supermarkets, milk was delivered door-to-door by a milkman.
Yeah.
They would travel from house to house, delivering fresh milk and other dairy products each and every day, and building relationships with their customers. This was a physically demanding job that required managing a route and providing good customer service. However, as
Hold on now. They always talk about the mailman or the gardener. The milkman, boy, is this a... Hold on now. Husband is out. I know they be like friends and be cool and stuff, but just seeing that right there, he's like, look, hey, he's like, boss, look, I didn't touch her. As you can see, my hands are wide. Somebody took that picture.
Kitchens became more advanced, and milk became easy to pick up at the supermarket. The need for a door-to-door milkman became less necessary. Eventually, the job became obsolete altogether. Before fast food restaurants and convenience stores were on every corner, soda fountains were the popular place to get a soda, some ice cream, or other sweet treats. Soda jerks were responsible for serving these items to customers, using a variety of syrups, flavors, and ingredients to make a wide range of beverages and desserts. This was a job that required a lot of attention to detail and creativity. But as drive-in restaurants and later the fast food revolution took hold, the soda fountains located along Main Street, USA began to dry up, leaving soda jerks to look for a new profession. Before automatic telephone exchanges, switchboard operators were responsible for manually connecting telephone calls. These operators would use a switchboard to connect callers with the person they were trying to reach. This was a confusing job that required good concentration to ensure the lines weren't crossed. But as automated and more accurate systems became available, the need for a manual switchboard operator just wasn't there.
Yeah, this one seems like very, very difficult. Like, you talking about trying to make sure lines aren't crossed and stuff. That's, whew. I know, like, I'm thinking about all these. I don't know how long they did it for, but I'm just looking at, like, think about the carpal tunnel that would happen with your fingers.
Prior to alarm clocks, people relied on someone called a knocker-upper to wake them up in the morning.
A knocker-upper?
Knocker-uppers were very common in England, and the practice even made its way to the United States. Knocker-uppers would travel door-to-door, tapping on windows with a long pole to wake people up. Today, this might be seen as creepy, but without alarm clocks, it was difficult for some to wake up on their own. Fortunately, technology advanced, and this profession was left for the history books.
A knocker-upper, that is wild.
Before desktop publishing software was invented, typesetters were responsible for creating all printed materials. These typesetters would use mechanical typesetting machines to set type that would then be inked and pressed onto paper. This is how newspapers and magazines were published before computers, and the job required a skilled typesetter to work fast to meet deadlines. This was truly an art form, but as digital printing made publishing easier, the need for typesetters declined, and the job became obsolete.
Jeez, man.
Some factories used to have people who would read stories out loud in order to keep workers entertained. This practice of hiring lectors appeared mainly in tobacco factories in the late 1800s, and the lectors themselves would actually audition for the job. Once hired, they would read what those workers wanted to hear, which was usually a combination of news and literature. Obviously, radios would go on to put lectors out of work, but nonetheless, it is still a fascinating job that is now gone. Before mass-produced metal products, blacksmiths were responsible for creating anything made with metal by hand. Blacksmiths would forge iron and steel into tools, weapons, and other products. This was a very physical job that brought with it many dangers, as they were working with molten metals. As the Industrial Revolution occurred, blacksmiths began to be replaced by machinists, and the demand for their hand-forged metal products declined, leading many blacksmiths to take up new professions, like shoeing horses. Prior to self-service gas station attendants would gladly pump gas, check oil levels, and clean windshields for customers. This was a convenient way for gas stations to draw in business, and it was a very popular practice up until the early 1970s. Following the oil crisis of 1973, gas stations looked for ways to save money, and cutting full-service attendants was the best way for them to survive. Self-service became the way gas stations operated from that point on, and the job of a gas station attendant became a thing of the past.
Humble. At a gas station called Humble.
Movie theaters once relied on film projectionists to operate and show movies. This was a complex job that required skilled knowledge of film projectors to actually show a movie on the big screen. As digital projectors became available, these complicated devices were slowly phased out. This meant that the job of a film projectionist would also be phased out, and the profession would become obsolete. Let me know in the comments if I missed anything, and maybe even consider supporting the channel over on Patreon.
Boy, I'm just trying to think, would you want any of this stuff back? If you had knocker-ups today with how crazy the world is, they'd be breaking into your house. You know what I mean? Oh, you still sleep? You ain't gonna get up? All right, cool. This is pretty crazy, man. It seemed like it was a lot of stuff to do back then. You know, and technology just came in and just swept it all out. Swept it all out. Man. But again, shout out to Recollection Roll for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Comment below if you did any of these jobs. How about that? Peace out.